properties of conductors. In case of conductors, these electrostatic parameters now we are going to discuss. Students, in conductors, electrons, some electrons are free to carry the charge. That is a charge carriers. And when this conductor is placed in a electric field, due to that external electric field that exerts some electric force, due to that force, these electrons move to the surfaces. That means whatever will be the extra charge there, that extra charge resides on the surfaces. In case of conductors, due to electrostatic repulsion, charge carriers, free electrons, resides only on the surface. Next, if this conductor is placed in a external electric field, due to that electrostatic force, these free charge carriers already now reaches the surface, that is resides on the surface. One more new electric field induced. This is induced electric field. This induced electric field cancels external electric field. That means inside a conductor, electrostatic field becomes zero. So that now we'll see in one example. Students, here one conducting material I am. This is one conducting material placed in external electric field. Electric field this side, external electric field right side. Due to this electric field, the free charge carriers, whatever may be there, yes, moved in the direction of electric field positive, opposite to electric field negative charge particles. We know the electric force F equal to Q into E. Yes, after reaching, these charge carriers induce one more electric field. So this is outer, this is induced. Applied electric field, induced electric field, both are now opposite to each other. Up to this induced electric field cancels external electric field, this charge carriers, yes, moment was there. Once induced charge, that is now induced electric field, cancels external electric field, then so now that charge carrier moment now stop. So now inside the conductor, resultant electric field becomes a zero. Resultant electric field becomes a zero. That means, students, here first point, charge resides on the surface of a conductor. Second point, inside a conductor, electric field zero. Yes, now come to next one. And one more point here, students. In case of a conductor, yes, inside this conductor, now just now we have seen net resultant electrostatic field is a zero. That means each and every point is at the same potential. So in case of a conductor, every point in a conductor is at the same potential. So that's why from high potential to low potential only electric field there. But here all points are at the same potential. So that's why electric field from same potential to same potential zero. That's why, students, now nearby the surfaces of conductors, there is no tangential electric field. Because surface means now at the same potential. That's why tangential electric field is zero, but normal electric field is. So that's why tangential electric field nearer to conducting charged surfaces is a zero. Now they have only normal electrostatic field. So total students, here 3 points now I cover. Number one, electric charges reside only on outer surfaces of a conductor. Number two, electric field, that is electrostatic electric field inside a conductor, zero. Number three, electric field nearer to charged conducting outer surfaces, tangential component to zero, but normal component to not zero. Okay, students, coming to another point. Yes, another property. Students, here now I am taking two conducting spheres. It is radius R1 and it is radius R2. Here charge Q1, here charge Q2 is there. Now these two conductors, now with the help of one conducting wire, these two I connected. Yes, already conductors. Again here conducting wire is there. Students, now definitely charge will move from high potential to low potential. High potential to low potential. Yes, after a moment, final charges here I am writing Q1 and Q. Small Q1, small Q2 before connection made. Capital Q1, capital Q2 after connection made. Now students, charge flow has been stopped. That means two conducting spheres come into same potential. That's why no charge flow. Yes, here capital Q1 by R1 equal to capital Q2 by R. Yes, once now equilibrium arised, Q1 by R1 equal to Q2 by R. Students, now here I am writing charge Q1 equal to sigma 1 means surface charge density on the first sphere. Sigma 1 into 4 pi R1 square divided by R1 equal to sigma 2 into 4 pi R2 square divided by R. Means final charge densities and radii, how related now I am going to prove just right. Yes, so from this now we come to know sigma 1 by sigma 2. Sigma 1 by sigma 2 equal to R2 by R. That means sigma is inversely proportional to radius. Students, now in case of a conducting surfaces, charge density, surface charge density is inversely proportional to radius of curvature. Is inversely proportional to radius of curvature. Okay? Yes, so that is now here complete proof. Yes, so students, now in case of conductors, one more property. Surface charge density is inversely proportional to radius of curvature. That means flat surfaces having more and more radius of curvature. So that's why sigma is very less. But for very sharp edges having less radius of curvature, yes, surface charge densities are very high. That means nearby the surface, nearby sharp edges, more surface charge density we can expect. Okay, student, this is another now property of a conductor. Okay, take this. Yes, now come to another. Yes, students, now just now completed. Nearby. Nearby conducting the surface. Tangential electric field zero, no doubt. But normal electric field not zero. That normal electric field, how much now I am going to prove? Just wait. Yes, student, it is now on charged conductor. Charged conductor. Yes, different radii of curvatures are there. So, student, suppose if you take this is very sharp edge, less radius of curvature, more charge density. Suppose if you take like this now, suppose it is almost flat, means radius of curvature almost infinity, very large. Yes, radius of curvature very large. Yes, automatically now sigma very, very less because inversely proportional to small. Okay, students, here any one point. Yes, now I am taking now here one point nearby. Yes, no doubt here tangential electric field G. But normal electric field means like this. This electric field question mark. Yes, here surface charge density sigma I am taking. To find now electric field, students, I am using Gauss principle. Yes, here Gauss principle, one Gaussian surface I am taking. One Gaussian surface. Yes, in this Gaussian surface, yes, curved surface, two flat surfaces, one flat surface is inside the conductor I have taken. We know, students, inside the conductor electric field is zero. And this area I am taking just A. This flat surface area A I am taking. Yes, Gauss law, total electric flux is nothing but enclosed charge divided by epsilon. Yes, here total flux. Here, students, flux is a E into A. Because here zero flux, only E into A. That equal to total charge sigma into A by epsilon. So therefore E equal to sigma by epsilon. So this is now normal component. But tangential component is a zero, no tangential component at all. Yes, so students, now please remember, nearby a conducting charged surface, electric field has only one component, that is normal component. That normal component is a sigma by epsilon naught. It is not sigma by 2 epsilon naught, sigma by epsilon naught. But tangential component to complete zero. Yes, take now one more property. All students, come on first. Yes, now students, now yes, same now charged conductor I have taken, some irregular shape, not a square, nothing, any shape, some irregular shape. But charged conductor, that is. Yes, here it is completely charged. Students, all now charges there on the surface, no doubt. But, yes, between two positive charges, there is electrostatic repulsion V. But here, more number of charges there on the surface. That's why definitely these all electric charges are being repelled. That means on the surface, electrostatic repulsive force is there. Now I am going to find out that electrostatic repulsive force are a unit area. Nothing but a electrostatic pressure. So our topic now, electrostatic pressure. electrostatic pressure. Of course, it is a repulsion. So now pressure, and also it is normal to the surface. This force, that's why now pressure exactly defined. Okay, students. Now here one small surface I am taking. On this surface, how much electrostatic force acting? First, I will find electrostatic force divided by that surface area. That is now surface area, for example, A. So that is nothing but a our electrostatic pressure. But how to find out electrostatic force on this small strip? Yes, now students, on this small strip, electric field due to remaining complete charges. Important now, students. Here electric field is not resultant electric field. No, this is the electric field due to this all complete charges except this. This electric field is nothing but a sigma by 2 epsilon naught. But including this means sigma by epsilon naught. But excluding this small strip is a sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So electric field due to remaining complete is a sigma by 2 epsilon. Yes, that we can prove also. Just wait. Suppose if you want to prove further, yes, I am not disturbing this. I am going for this. Yes, so students, suppose now here one small strip. Due to this strip, only due to this strip, electric field is even. Students, again, careful listen. Only due to this small strip, even is the electric field. Due to remaining complete charges, electric field is a even. Therefore, resultant is a even plus E. Similarly, just nearby here, due to this strip, electric field even this side. Due to remaining electric field even. Yes, this point just nearby, but clarity purpose now some distance I maintain. Yes, at this point E1 is electric field due to only this small strip charge. But E2, these two electric fields due to remaining the charges other than this small strip. Okay, right. Now here E1 and E2 both are opposite. That's why what is the resultant electric field? E1 minus V. But students, we know inside the conductor what is the electric field? Zero. So that's why students here, 0 equal to E1 minus E2. Therefore, E1 equal to E. Now, yes, here outside E1 plus E2 equal to sigma by epsilon naught. Because nearby a conducting charged surface, electric field sigma by epsilon previously proved already. So therefore E1 equal to already E2, 2 E1 equal to sigma by epsilon naught. So that's why, yes, 2 E1 equal to 2 E2 equal to sigma by epsilon naught. Yes, either E1 or E2 is nothing but sigma by 2 epsilon. So here E1 means what? Electric field due to only small strip. That is how much? Sigma by 2 epsilon. So therefore now, yes, E1 equal to E2 sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So therefore electric field nearby this due to remaining complete charge is a sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Same concept here. Yes, nearby this strip, what is the electric field due to remaining charge other than this? Sigma by 2 epsilon. So electric field into charge is nothing but a force. So that's why students here, suppose charge is a Q. This now charge is a Q. Electric field into charge Q is a force. Force by area is a pressure. Yes, now here surface charge density sigma I am using. So therefore, students, electric field completed and the force F equal to sigma into A Q sigma by 2 epsilon R. So from that, pressure equal to force per area. Yes, A cancel out. Sigma square by 2 epsilon. So electrostatic pressure, that is now electric force acting on unit area of surface, sigma square by 2 epsilon. Sigma square by 2 epsilon. Yes, all students, please take that. Yes, electrostatic pressure also completed, students. Now come to, yes, continuation from electrostatic pressure. Students, here I am taking one complete sphere. This is now conducting charged sphere. Conducting charged sphere. Conducting charged sphere, that is radius capital R, charge capital Q. Yes, because it is a conductor. Whatever the charge given to this, yes, completely distributed over surface, that is also uniformly distributed, because students already know sigma is inversely proportional to radius of curvature, we proved. But here it is a sphere, every point on the surface having the same radius of curvature, so that's why now sigma is a uniform, that is a constant. Yes, here sigma is nothing but capital Q divided by 4 pi R square. That is constant uniform. So that's why any point if you take electrostatic pressure sigma square by 2 epsilon naught. Now, students, it is one hemisphere, it is another hemisphere. Yes, here electrostatic pressure, that is normally acting now away from the center. So that's why here and here and here and here, like that, complete all points, electrostatic repulsion is there. If you take a complete sphere, resultant force is a zero because all sides cancel. That's why I'm taking, students, only one hemispherical part. Only on this hemispherical part, how much electrostatic force is acting? How much electrostatic force is acting? Yes, so students, now here you can find out the force in two ways. Directly now, electrostatic pressure into area is nothing but a force. But here, area direction from here to here complete, each and every point to different areas, directions are different. That's why one small integration required. This is method one. Method two, yes, just like now in our fluid statics, force from the pressure by using projection method, you can find them. The second method also. Okay, now I am using integration method, you simply find. Yes, to find now complete force, students, here I am taking one small circular region. This circular region is making an angle theta, and d theta is a small angle. From here to here, students, it is capital R sine theta, nothing but a radius of the circle. Yes, only on this circular part. Only on this circular part. Force is a df. That is nothing but sigma square by 2 epsilon naught into area. What is that area? 2 pi r sine theta into r d theta. That is now force on only on this circular area. This force now I am resolving. One is df cos theta. Another is df sin theta. But from the symmetry students, df sin theta cancel out. Only df cos theta is there. So that's why now I'm going to integrate this df cos theta. Yes. Net force on hemisphere, integral df cos theta. Df cos theta. From 0 to 90 degrees means from here to here because only hemisphere. Yes, df is nothing but this total into cos theta. Sin theta, d theta, cos theta for the integration. Integral sin theta, cos theta, d theta, that is nothing but sin square theta by 2. After substitution of the limits now, that is from 0 to 90, you will get 1 by 2. So now force F on hemisphere is sigma square by 2 epsilon naught 2 pi r square into 1 by 2, that is pi r square. Suppose students, if you use projection method just like in our fluid statics, up to here you will get no direct answer. Pressure into projection area pi r square. So sigma square by 2 epsilon naught into pi r square. So therefore, force acting on hemisphere. So this sphere, sigma square. Sigma place you can substitute Q by 4 pi r square. So now sigma square, Q square divided by 4 square is 16. Pi r square, 1 pi r square cancel, but still 1 pi r square is there because whole square. And then 2 epsilon. Yes, so students, after substitution, I am writing Q square divided by 16 into 2, that is 32. Yes, pi r square, 1 completed. Yes, still 1 is there, pi r square and epsilon. Yes, students, this is electrostatic force acting on only one hemispherical part of charged conducting complete sphere. Okay. Yes, from here to here, come on, fast take that. That force also completed. Yes, so students, now properties of conductors. Number one, charge resides only on outer surface of conductors. Number two, electrostatic electric field inside the conductor is zero. Number three, yes, whatever may be the conductor point, all points are at the same potential. That is the electrostatic potential. Next two, yes, electric field just nearby the charged surface has only one component, that is normal component, no tangential component. That normal component is a sigma by epsilon naught. Next, yes, now on charged conducting surface, yes, electrostatic pressure is acting, that is nothing but sigma square by 2.